lot. Yes, on any time of day.
Zumba demonstration. So we're going to play a little bit of music and then we're going to get our first lot of entertainment on. So welcome to morning. Hopefully the sun's going to come out. And if you walk up and down the street, you'll soon find some vintage cars up at the top. And down at the bottom, look for the donkeys. Because there's a load of donkeys walking around. And there's a couple of donkeys down there as well. Yes, all the way from Peru. Right, so we're going to play a little bit of background music and get our summer demonstration ready. So enjoy yourselves on St. George's Day. See you in a minute. All the way from Canada, Mr. Michael Bublé. So I'm going to see if he's ready. Are you ready? Oh, yeah, but let's do it. We'll see if he's here. He really can't come. We've advertised him, he's got to come. Oh, we've got his brother. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've got Michael Bublé's brother, Harry Bublé. No, I know we haven't fooled you, it's not really him. Once again, welcome to Morley Town Centre for St. George's Day. Hopefully the weather's going to stay like this. We've a lot of stuff going around with donkey rides, fun fair rides. There's some vintage cars and an old fire engine up there. Fabulous donuts down here, I've been told. I'm going to try one a little bit later. And you have loads of entertainment coming on throughout the afternoon as well until about 3:30, 4 o'clock. Now I'm going to sing a few songs for you now, so we're going to do that top one, my friend. Here we go. Let's see you doing some reggae.
Take the ribbons from my
tonight. Pete Goss, me with Molly.
Yes.
All together, fight! So we're going to introduce Paige and another singers, and they're going to sing a song together. And they go as Sisters by Soul.
Like us on Facebook.
And I got
leave
it right.
On Facebook, yes. Do it.
So we'll leave you with the Capable Bands and the Beverly Sisters. Yes?
See you dancing, guys!
heaven will touch.
What we're needing now is for the civil dignitaries to be coming downstairs, if there should be there, that man to do so, and then what we can do, we can get the parade marshal to call the parade to order. I think one or two of the people's going to have to come by, particularly with the Willis Jeep. Steadying on the horse, building his head in the horse, if you will. It's good with dragons, I don't always like machine, and with the jeeps, so they...
Come on,
as I say, these people will be doing reenactments up on the top field, up at the rugby field, at Scatcherd Lane there. If you want to see them, I'll be able to tell you what time they're on, and various different reenactments taking place today with all the volunteers here. And as I say, once we get up there, we've got the usual three-ring circus for you, to entertainment on the cricket field, and lots of stalls that's up there. I've seen one or two of them being setting up this morning when I was on my way now, so you've got plenty of entertainment in the cricket field, on the rugby field, and in the top field, and also plenty of stalls, local people on those for you to support. As we said earlier, for those who've just arrived, please take care, keep the kids at arm's length, and keep your dog on a lead. And I know it's also, when you've stood about, it's easy for you to put things down and leave them. Please try not to do that, and leave any unattended packages, because it can cause a problem.
Don't worry, I can edit that bit out.
Well, on with it.
Representing the Queen, we've got the Vice Lord Lieutenant, Tim Hare, the Mayor of Morley, Councillor Wyn Kidger, and visiting mayors from Featherston, from Normanton, and from South Kirby and Moorside. I think that's Moorthorpe. I don't know, but I'll check that later. So we offer a warm welcome to all our visitors on the steps, and a warm welcome to anybody who's visiting the Morley for the first time. As you can see, we do quite a bit of a turn for St George's Day. Evidently, you had a lovely day yesterday, and there was a lovely service in what was the Leeds Parish Church, on last Thursday. We're going to wrap it off today with a lovely day, as you can see, wonderful sunshine, plenty of entertainment up at Scatcherd Lane, which I've already told you about down here. Up next, what we're going to do is medal the dust with me. Ladies and gentlemen, St George, to lead off the parade. Big round of applause. That's the volunteers for the next big round of applause for them. We've got the Morley Rugby Club football
on the rugby field. And also, as you would imagine, on the cricket field we've also got some cricket competitions as well. So Bobby Rugby Football Club Junior is here, give us a big round of applause for that as well.
Thank you. I'm 47.
Song, as it were, and try and help you forget, perhaps for a while, your drab, wretched lives.
I don't understand, I mean, with the, I'm with you, huh? Ready for love, let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the place. Come on with the rain, have a smile on my face. I walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing in the rain.
Come over that particular ground there, they'll make excellent targets for the Germans to shoot at them, and that's what the NCOs and officers will be waiting for. And the Americans pushing forward. It looks like the Americans in any recent drill dump, which was the first opportunity of course. And it looks like the American 82nd are going to take the fuel dump in tonight. Germans not retreating at all. Remember, the Germans had 2-3 years to prepare these positions in Normandy. It's an extremely brave thing. The Allies to do seaborne invasion into these heavily defended German positions. So both sides are going to give no quarter in this. The Germans retreated to their defensive position, being well prepared. You can see the American Allies pointing over the ridge there, keeping their heads down. I can see, I don't think the German soldiers can yet. Now the fuel dump in Allied hands, exactly what they wanted. Taking the fuel, which is exactly what he wanted to do. Remember, this fuel is the lifeblood of the German army. Now the officer, the German officer, is at the back with the British tommy there. He's got his hands above on his shoulder. Over for you, Fritz. Now then, oh heck, look at him! He's got a grenade! He's from the Majors fuel dump! Oh no! Has lost all his fuel. Oh dear. But saying that, he's won the battle. Let's give him a really good round of applause. He lost all his fuel, but he won the battle. We act as an affront here. And we're going to give him a really good smashing round of applause. We're going to line them all up in front of you, and you're going to get really nice and close to see what it's like to have a sweaty World War II soldier in front of you. Okay, officers, and let's see you NCOs, get all your men lined up, and we're going to give them a really good smashing round of applause. All these reenactors do it for nothing. It's our first reenactment of the season. It's all
Association! Remove! Headdress! Association! Replace! Headdress!
Give yourselves a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Give our people a round of applause. Oh, it's Katie on the trumpet. Fantastic. Really, really good display. You've got a fantastic audience. And here, does a brilliant job. Superb. Mr. Kevin Molly. Shows for the history field. Thank you for coming, thank you for spending some time with us, and thanks for celebrating St. George's Day with us. Give yourself a big round of applause. We'll stand here in the gap, so please do come and talk to us, come talk to the historians. Go see what we get into, plus please enjoy us as well.
Thank you.